Hello, I'm Atubo George, and I'm so excited to be bringing God's truth to you today. Now, happy new month. We just stepped into the sixth month of the year 2021. Now, this is the month of June, praise God. Now, the year is advancing, and I'll tell you what, God is advancing your life also, praise God. I want to tell you something. God knew this year before you stepped into it. God knew the month of June already. He knows the end from the beginning. He's not trying to understand the month with you, see? He already knows the end. He knows everything He has planned for you this month. Now, this is the reason you should be excited. Now, if you are not joining already our fasting and prayer meetings today, get involved. Get involved. The link is on the screen. Join the next prayer meeting at the next watch. We pray about 40 minutes every watch. Join us. Now, we're going to be fasting. Even if you don't tell me, oh, I didn't know there was a fast, I wasn't fasting. Join the prayer meeting. And next month, plan to fast with us. Praise God. Listen, God is doing great things in our lives. And He's taking us step by step. Now, this month is going to be a great month. You know why? Because of what the Lord has laid in my heart to share with you this week. Now, I'm going to be starting that today. But since today is the first of the month, I just want to bless you. Listen, the presence of God goes with you throughout this month. I pray that the Spirit of God will carry you by Himself. You know, Jesus said something. He said, when the Spirit of truth is come, He will guide you into all truth. Therefore, I declare over your life this month of June, you will never walk in a lie. You will never assume a lie. You will never listen to a lie. You will never agree with a lie in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Everything that is not of the truth, you will not be a partaker of it. The Spirit of God will remind you. He will remind you of His word, which is truth. He will instruct you, telling you to turn away from the way of lies. Praise God. Anyone who comes around your life to deceive you, and anyone who's already deceiving you right now, I declare in the name of the Lord Jesus, by the Spirit of God, you are being torn away from that deceit. In the name of the Lord Jesus, whoever it is, a business partner, one who's pretending to be in a relationship with you, I declare in the name of the Lord Jesus, this month, in fact, this week, such people are being exposed in your life. The Spirit of God is guiding you into all truth. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I just feel so strong in my spirit that there's someone who's going to be yanked out of such deceit. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I bind the spirit of lies. The Bible talks about lie. The liar is the devil. Because Jesus said he's been a liar from the beginning, and He is the father of all lies. So you have no fellowship with the devil, praise God. And that's why Jesus gave us the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is not in our life just to make us speak in tongues and to feel spooky and to prophesy and to, you know, show so much power. Yes. We demonstrate the power of the Holy Spirit in our lives. But most importantly, for your personal guidance, the Holy Spirit is in you. And He is the one that will tell you, hey, don't listen to that fellow anymore. He's telling lies. See, someone will come with a wonderful package, wonderful business plan, wonderful idea, and you are getting interested and you are just listening to it. Hey, remember that the Holy Spirit has been given to you to guide you into all truth. You know what it means to be guided into all truth? Sometimes, you know, the Holy Spirit wants to guide you, but you don't want to be guided. You just want to hear Him talk to you, see? Many times He will not talk to you like you think He will talk to you. But He does the job of guiding. You know what to guide means? Hey, turn left. You turn left. Go right now. You go right. Stop there. Look up. Wow. Is this what is in this place? Yes, that's what he does. He guides you into all truth, praise God. So sometimes he will make you discover things, and you come to the conclusion, or you make your decisions by the things he will show you. Now, all you need to be sure about is that he is the one guiding you, praise God. And that's what he's going to be doing to you this month. You are going to receive great guidance like never before. I'm telling you, this month, you will hear people talking about things that look so believable. I mean, things that look so real. Rumors that look so real. But you will hear him in your heart telling you, don't listen to them. That's not the truth. Praise God. And I'll tell you what, this month, don't respond to rumors. Don't hear, you know, lots of fake news flying over the place. How do you deal with fake news as a child of God? God has already dealt with fake news. Praise God. How did he deal with fake news? He gave you the Holy Spirit. And Jesus said he will guide you into all truth. So don't be quick to, you know, someone sends you a message like, wow, see what's going on. Let me forward it to everybody on my phone. No, pause. And say, Holy Spirit, is this the truth concerning this situation? Because you don't want to join those spreading a lie. Because when you spread a lie, you've taken up the ministry of the devil. And you don't want that in your life. You don't want to send out something and realize, oh, it was a wrong information. Now you'll be thinking, wow, how do I withdraw this? And let me tell you this, you know, Jesus said something. He said, I am the light of the world. Anyone who follows me will never walk in darkness, but he shall have the light of life. Hey, guess what? That should be your testimony. What testimony? That anyone who listens to you, anyone who follows your path, you know what I mean by that? Anyone who follows your advice, anyone who follows your counsel will never walk in darkness. They are not going to wake up one day and say, what have I gotten into? Praise God. No, that's not going to happen with you. Anyone who listens to you, anyone who follows you will always be thankful. See? They will always be thankful. That's exactly what it means to have the light of life. And Jesus said, if you follow him, you will have the light of life. You know what the light of life is? You will never walk in a lie. So what is the light of life in truth? The Holy Spirit is the light of life. Praise God. Yeah, he is the light of life. How does he operate? By speaking to you every time. You want to do anything? Holy Spirit, what do you think about this? See, he's the one that will now tell you, go ahead. Or he's the one that will tell you, hold on. Wait for 2 weeks. Wait for 1 month. Don't take that decision yet. Don't be in a hurry to take very important decisions. Think it through. Put it through the Spirit of God. Put it through his test. Check your heart. Are you being greedy right now? Because sometimes you make hasty decisions because of greed. You make hasty decisions because of what you think you're going to gain from it. Pause a moment. See? And when I begin to share the things the Lord have put in my heart to share with you from tomorrow, you will begin to understand these things very well. Praise God. So pause in your heart before you take that decision. Whenever someone is telling you, hey, you need to decide now, I just know that that's not the right decision to take. Praise God. No, it's not. Never. No matter what it is. I remember I've shared this testimony many times. You know, my wife and I, you know, the first day of our marriage, and that was her first pregnancy, and she was bleeding, and went to the hospital. They said, oh, it's a miscarriage. And then they began to tell us all sort of things. They began, you need to evacuate, and then you need to do this, you need to do that, you need to do that. And say, you have to do it fast, you have to do it now, you have to, you know. I looked at all these doctors talking to me, you know, this one will go talk to a senior colleague and come back and tell us, look, and you better. You know, all these things trying to pressure me to take a decision. I turned to my wife, I said, you know what? We are going home. He said, would you go home? I said, yes. And then I turned to the doctor. I said, you know what? If we don't do this right now, is my wife going to die? He said, well, you just have to be fast about it. I said, thank you. I told my wife, let's go home. And when we got into the car, I said to her, I said, listen, the Lord haven't spoken to me yet, so I can't be in a hurry. I can't be pressured into taking that kind of decision. Let's go home. And then we got home and held our hands and began to pray. And the Lord spoke to us and told us exactly what we needed to do and told us exactly where we needed to go. Praise God. And we obeyed the Lord and went there, and the story was different. Praise God. Yeah. And you know, sometimes people take medical decisions in a hurry and get into trouble. Now, we are not against doctors, see? But sometimes, you see, because they operate on a system that may be blind sometimes. Doctors have been wrong before, see? So as a child of God, when you visit a doctor, you don't just listen to everything he tells you. You've got to be listening to the Spirit of Truth, who will help you guide the doctor. Praise God. Yeah, you may not be a doctor, but you when the doctor is doing the test and telling you all stuff, you're like, hold on, can you check this and so thing? But I don't think that. No, can you just check it? Why? Because you hear it in your spirit. See? And the doctors check like, oh, wow, yeah. Actually, that's the problem. Say, yeah, that's the problem. See, I may not know everything about medicine. But you see, and that's why you listen. While you're listening upwards also. So while the doctor is explaining, the Holy Spirit will tell you, call a name, you know, tell you, check this one. This particular thing he just said, knock it off. This one he's still talking about now. Tell him to check properly. Now, that's how you do. Praise God. And that's how you stay safe. God wants you safe. He wants you well. Hallelujah. And so I pray for you right now that this month of June, you will not be involved in any kind of accident. Praise God. Now, I'm not just talking about physical motor accident. I'm talking about any kind of accident, anything that is called accident. You will not be involved in it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray that the Spirit of God will guide every step you take this month. You will see through His eyes. You will hear His voice in every way. I pray in all your journeys, safety is yours. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Spirit of God is carrying you by Himself. And I declare all your needs are met this month. Hey, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Oh, the Spirit of God is present in your life even right now. Thank you, Lord. I see migraine headache. Yes, migraine headache leaving someone right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus, you can put your hand on your head and I command that pain to go now in Jesus' name. You are free. You are free. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Stomach pains are being healed. Yeah, issues with the stomach, whatever it is that is giving you trouble in your stomach, you are healed right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus, you can stand up and bend forward and just check yourself. It is gone. Praise God. Praise God. I'm telling you, it's going to be an exciting month. You know why? Because the Lord have gone ahead of you. He has made every crooked path straight. So you know what that means? You are going to be walking on straight paths. Praise God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Just go ahead and bless His name right now. He is God. He is loving. He loves you so much. And He's bringing Himself to make you know Him. Praise God. That's the most important knowledge you can have. The knowledge of the Most High God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You are blessed this month. Everything you lay your hands to do in the month of June will prosper. Failure is far from you. Receive this now in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. I'll see you tomorrow. Until then, have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.